Wait, slow down. Okay, hold on, let it sit real quick. Hold on, let it sit real quick. Here, look, it's burning. Oh, fast.
Slow down.
La ceremonia apache de la danza del amanecer, Naíes, forma parte del folclore tribal. Se trata de una ceremonia sagrada que celebra la pureza, además de una tradición familiar que se transmite de generación en generación. La ceremonia de la danza del amanecer de Kiana se desarrollará durante 4 días y 4 noches en la reserva apache de la Montaña Blanca, en Pine Top, Arizona, en territorio sagrado. Es viernes, el primer día de la ceremonia, y Kiana intenta encender el fuego siguiendo el método tradicional.
The first stage of Kiana Sunrise Dance is building a fire. To us in the native language, fire gives us life, food, warmth, and protection. And so building this fire for Kiana, she wanted to go primitive, challenging herself as her first stage of celebrating her being a woman till her last day on earth, that she knows that she could, you know, face challenges and overcome them. And she thought that doing this bow drill would help her in that way. Even though she came close to making fire primitively, she still felt like she could face challenges from here on out. So that's one of the first stages in building that fire.
In our Apache culture, the drum can mean a lot of things, but the main thing that it means is kind of represents the body. Like, for example, the drumstick represents all the bones in our body. The leather that we use for our drum represents the skin. The water, if you can hear it, represents the blood in our body. And the rubber represents God, who holds us all together, and the can of the drum represents Mother Earth because it's circular around, and the drum beat represents the heartbeat that we all have, and it represents a whole new body, like pretty much us. The whole drum is us, and when you're drumming, when you can just listen and you can feel the heartbeat start to match up with the drum.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Seriously, one wing.
I'll wear these ones because they match with my dress.
Okay. Opening them up?
Yes, please.
This is my hut. I call it my house because I'm gonna be living here until I get undressed, which is Monday, is where my godmother is gonna take off my buckskin outfit and my cane. She's gonna take everything off of my cane, and then she's gonna take the abalone shell off of my forehead, and she's gonna take the feather off of my hair, and that's the day the whole ceremony ends, and that's the day I get undressed. And also during my sunrise dance, I can't touch myself, I can't move my hair or anything. They'll give me a necklace that has like a stick so I can drink water out of. And if I use a cup, people say that ladies will grow beards that way. But that's why you use the stick to drink out of. And then also you'll have an itching stick. So you'll pull your hair back with the itching stick, and then you can itch yourself anywhere you guys need to. If it's like on your leg, you'll take off the necklace, itch it, and then put it back on. And the cane will help you, because when you get old, you'll need a cane to help you with it. And so you use that cane when you get old. And I say I can't touch babies because babies are, I'm like transitioning into womanhood, and I don't wanna have babies early in life. And I wanna finish college, school, and everything. And I wanna travel the world first before I have kids or anything. That's why most people say stomach issues shouldn't touch babies.
Kiana, su familia y sus amigos preparan una comida especial para los que han llegado y para el intercambio de alimentos y regalos con el campamento de los padrinos. La ceremonia siempre se lleva a cabo en el verano, empezando un viernes y terminándose un lunes. Para Kiana, la ceremonia será una prueba de resistencia y un momento para entrar en contacto con su espiritualidad. Es una bendición para su paso de niña a mujer que la preparará para la vida y la hará más fuerte.
Chose a piece of ground that's never been used before. They cleared the land. They put up structures. They created a cook area, two dance areas, and they made two separate camps, one for each family. And the families stay separate, and then they come together at different times during the ceremony. So it's really been an experience.
Hey! But I believe with how many people here today, it can rain tomorrow. If it was up to each and every one of us. Our prayer times 150 will be a strong prayer up above that He will bless us with. But you gotta have faith. Believe in Him. Pray for the person standing, sitting next beside you. This is how it says in the Bible. Jesus saying, treat like brothers and sisters. If you see someone down on their knees, give him a helping hand. Bring him back up. Show him back to the straight path. This is what all we want. Not just for ourselves, but for her. Just like our heartbeat. How doctors monitor it. It shoots up, shoots down. Shoots up halfway down. Skyrockets back up. That's how our life is. It ain't always rainbows all the time. As you all may know, go through struggles. The way life was meant to be, each and every one of us. Put in your thoughts and prayers this whole weekend that the troubles that we face, that she can overcome easily, that she will have that general knowledge to make the right choice when a stump falls in front of her path. She will never be alone when at times it feels like we may be. But with prayer, prayer is everything. But remember prayer. Thank you for each and every one of you for listening to me. Thank you.
Durante la ceremonia de vestimenta, el curandero Odiin indica a la madrina dónde colocar cada herramienta sagrada que él mismo ha fabricado y bendecido. Para empezar, la madrina le pone a Kiana un vestido de ante que simboliza el animal sagrado. Los dibujos de su vestido representan a los espíritus. La concha de abulón atada a su cabello y colocada a la altura de su frente es un símbolo de la mujer cambiante. La pluma de águila en su cabello le servirá de guía y le dará fuerza. El sagrado bastón Gish Ezaa que recibe Kiana le proporciona fuerza y apoyo. Las cintas atadas al bastón representan los colores cardinales: negro, azul, amarillo y blanco. Las plumas del águila representan lo más noble, fuerte y sagrado para los apaches.
Yeah. I'm Kiana's grandfather. I'm here today supporting her and her sunrise dance, traditional native ceremony, bringing a girl into her adulthood. My son, Chris, her father, unfortunately, isn't here. He was killed in a car accident about 10 years ago. But he contributed very much to her sunrise today. He was so happy to have a little girl that by the time she was 3 years old, he had already made moccasins and tanned special deer skins for her ceremony, and contributed a lot to her day today.
My husband and I have never seen this before, and it's quite an event and quite an undertaking. So it's really been an experience, and it is so special because it's our granddaughter. Our son wasn't able to be here, and when he had that little girl, he was so excited to have a little girl. And just like my husband said, he made all these things ahead of time. And they were so surprised when they went through some of his garage that he had things stored in. And he had had all the hides tanned. And our son used to always call her Princess. And she looked like a princess. So this has been a real experience.
La danza de la primera noche se llama Bedilti. Es una ceremonia compuesta de 32 canciones y bailes que sirve de ejercicio físico para fortalecer el cuerpo de Kiana. Las canciones sagradas representan un viaje espiritual a través de las distintas etapas de la vida. Kiana se conecta con el legado espiritual de sus ancestros para acompañarla en su transición hacia la feminidad. El segundo día, el sábado temprano, durante la Nesda, Kiana baila de rodillas, balanceándose de un lado a otro, tocando a la Madre Tierra en el norte y tocándola en el sur, canción tras canción. Kiana bailará durante varias horas. Es una prueba intensa que requiere resistencia física y espiritual. La madrina de Kiana la masajea de pies a cabeza para proporcionarle fuerza física, buena disposición y longevidad. La madrina coloca su mano varias veces sobre la boca de Kiana para que solo pronuncie las palabras adecuadas.
¡Suscríbete!
También bendice su oreja para que solo escuche cosas positivas. Kiana se está convirtiendo en la mujer cambiante, la primera mujer en la tierra y madre de todas las mujeres apache. Una vez que su madrina ha terminado de correr, toma el bastón sagrado y se lo entrega a Kiana para continuar con otros rituales que el curandero guía con una canción.
This dance has been really tough for everybody, but it's been a lot of fun. This is Kiana's journey from being a girl to being a woman, and it's been pretty hard, but it's been really fun. She's learned a lot. She's learned how to pray, and she's learned how to just be tough in general. And not only that, but also just how to respect the four directions and how that is where the Native Americans breathe all life has come from. So the east is where the black, south is the blue, east is the yellow, and north is the white. And they believe that that's where all the life has come from.
Kiana correrá cuatro veces hacia el este, el sur, el oeste y el norte. Las carreras simbolizan las diferentes etapas de la vida de una mujer: la infancia, la adolescencia, la edad adulta y la vejez. Kiana agradece a las cuatro montañas sagradas, los manantiales, los animales y las plantas medicinales, y bendice a las personas que viven en cada una de las cuatro direcciones. Kiana y su familia expresan generosidad con ofrendas de frutas, dulces y bebidas.
Thank you.
El padrino deja caer dinero, caramelos, chicles y otras golosinas sobre Kiana para que tenga buena suerte y prosperidad en la vida. El curandero bendice a Kiana, a su compañera y a sus padrinos con polen amarillo sagrado para que la ceremonia sea exitosa y que estén protegidos del peligro. También son bendecidos por los familiares de Kiana y otros miembros de la tribu. Durante la ceremonia, Kiana es considerada como un ser puro y sagrado, que tiene poderes curativos especiales. La gente acude a ella para ser bendecida y curada. Tarde en la noche, llega la hora de los bailarines de la corona, conocidos también como Gaan o espíritus de la montaña. Tienen un papel sagrado en la ceremonia, pues ahuyentan a los espíritus negativos y atraen bendiciones. También enseñan a los apache a quererse los unos a los otros. En esa noche, se cantan 32 canciones especiales para el baile de la corona.
Thank you.
El tercer día, el domingo, un curandero reza cerca del tipi, Gowa, que se ha convertido en un altar antes de la ceremonia de pintura, un ritual para la protección de Kiana. Los miembros de la tribu bendicen a los cuatro bailarines de la corona y al payaso con polen amarillo. Los bailarines de la corona y el padrino cubren a Kiana con una mezcla de arcilla y harina de maíz que no se puede quitar mientras dure la ceremonia.
dance itself, you know, it's designed to be challenging, because they always used to say Apaches were tough, they were strong. We always say we had the same belief as you did, it's just we have a different way of, it was presented differently through us, you know? Our language is different, you know? What we had readily available to us was different, you know? The whole world is made by God, Yosin. The crown dancers who you saw, you know, depending on the translation, you know, they could mean angels as well. The last one, the clown, you know, he's basically like the go-between between the modern world, you know, us as humans and the angels, you know, because if we hear them speak, they could shatter your ears. But he's the leader.
Empiezan los numerosos intercambios de regalos entre campamentos.
Because one of them has an iPhone gift card and one of them has something else. So whichever one has the iPhone, that's yours.
Thank you.
iPhone?
gift card.
Magic words, gift card.
What's an iPhone gift card?
I'm going 1-800 now.
Yeah. be told what to do.
Jump on it. If once you know that something needs to get done, do it. You know what's best for you. Whatever decision that they make, I mean, you may not agree with it all the time, but down the road, you'll realize that they really care about you. They wanted what was best for you. Think about the people that came in for you. Think about the people that work on your camp here, digging post holes, whatnot. Apache is so loved, different. Apaches work hard for one another to show that they love you. Well, it was a great honor singing out here. 505, books. What about it being the books? You have any questions, anything? First one? Okay, I'll be quiet. I'm sure it was a great experience for you. You know what to expect. If anything, down the road, maybe someone's gonna be knocking on that door, gonna surprise you now, maybe.
Next time, we're gonna have it at Cardinal Stadium.
I'm sure you gained a lot of knowledge from this ceremony.
And as I learned more and more about it, I realized what a big obligation, big commitment I was making. And I'm learning every day about my husband's culture. I'm supposed to come by Kiana just like a mom, just like I am a mom to my other two children. Now I have Kiana as a daughter. And I share her with her mom. And I'm to lead her on the way to making good choices, being a strong, powerful woman, finishing her education. If she meets Mr. Right along the way, making sure that he's Mr. Right, just like a mom would do. Being there for her until I take my last breath, just like I would for my other two kids, just like I do for my husband. And that's what this whole ceremony was about.
And I'm also proud of my wife, you know, it's you've never seen this, oh, I've never seen it before, and there's the talk around the town is nobody really ever seen it, you know, maybe you hear once in a while, you know, a non-native does this, you know, but it's rare. A bunch of emotions went through my body, my head, you know, when I learned that she got offered, you know, to be a godmother. So I was very happy, very happy, very proud. And I'm glad we did it together. You know, we all give each other strength in there. And there's a lot of things that go through your head when you're going through this, you know, besides the pain, the getting tired, lack of sleep and everything, you know. You know, who's important to you really comes out. And I always knew my wife was very important to me, but the ceremony made it even stronger.
El cuarto día, el lunes por la mañana, una vez que la madrina de Kiana la ha desvestido y el curandero ha pronunciado las últimas oraciones sagradas, Kiana, su madrina y otros familiares y amigos bendicen su vestimenta ritual y sus elementos sagrados con el polen amarillo. Se guardan y nunca volverán a utilizarse.
Hay que hacer algo. 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 Hay que hacer algo
Oh, I got one better. Put it ID. So I'll give it up. I'm going to okay, whatever it is. But I think that's all. Put an ID. Yeah. Yeah.
The Sunrise Dance was a great experience for me and all the other people that came. I definitely do feel stronger, mentally and physically. It takes a lot of time preparing for it. I feel more grown up, you know. It's pretty sad though, it's over. I'm glad it's over because it took about 5 months training. They just don't feel like singing anymore, but that's the first time I've ever seen them very happy singing, enjoying themselves. It was a good experience. I bet me and my family were very proud of me. I was extremely proud of me. I was thinking, I can't do this, I can't do this, I'm tired, let me sit down. But I was fine. I just kept not thinking about the heat or anything. I was good. It was good. I feel great now.